Hello everyone, welcome to another episode of Daily LeetCode Challenge, and today's question is flip binary tree to match pre-order reversal. Even before going on to the question, let me just wish you a very happy Holi. Keep yourself and your family safe and play very safe and secured Holi. So let's walk through the question. The question says you are given a binary tree of n nodes and each node has a value assigned from 1 to n and there is no duplication allowed. Also, you are given the expected pre-ordered reversal that should match the pre-ordered reversal of the binary tree. And if it doesn't match, you can perform swapping operations between the two child of the binary tree. So you are allowed to do as many swaps in the tree. And what you need to do, you need to tell the number of nodes that are to be swapped so that the pre-ordered reversal of the tree becomes equal to the expected pre-ordered reversal. If that is possible. Otherwise, you simply return -1 as your answer. So let's try and understand the approach by the presentation that I have created for this. And let me just start the slideshow. Let me just take a pen. And the most important thing to understand in this question is that all the nodes are unique, starting from 1 till n, and there's no duplication allowed. Had it been the question with duplicates, the approach would have been totally different. So let's take a very simple example that was specified in the question. We have 1 as a root node and 2 as its left child and right child as 3. The pre-ordered reversal is current node, left child and then right child, CLR. And what is the expected pre-ordered reversal that the 3 pre-ordered reversal should match after swapping the nodes if needed? It is 1, 3 and 2. And this is the current pre-ordered reversal that I have written. If you traverse this tree in a pre-ordered traversal, you will get 1, 2 and 3 because this node is the first node that you will currently visit and then you'll move on to the left and then to the right. So let's try and devise the algorithm. It's not a very difficult problem. We have done similar kind of problems in the past and we'll be doing it by the recursion approach. So let's start with the DFS approach. And here, what we are going to do, we will check whether the current node is equal to the expected node or not. If that is the case, then we are good to go. Otherwise, we'll simply return and reject all the calculations that we have done so far because it's not possible to generate the expected pre-ordered reversal. For example, if this was given to be 2 instead of 1 and 1 would have been there, if this would have been 3, 2 and 2, 3 and 1, there would have been no case in which you can generate this pre-ordered reversal for this given tree. That means you need to simply reject the case and return -1 as your answer. So let's move back to this case where we get 1 and then we will check whether its left child dot current node matches with the next value in the list. If this matches, then it's well and good. Otherwise, the right side may or may not match depending upon the DFS traversal. So what I'm trying to say, there could be a case where 2 doesn't match with 3, as in this case. That means the right child would be matching with the current node and we need to perform one swap operation there. So we will add 1 to our swapping node list. So we'll maintain a swapping node list and we will add 1 to it. And we will continue the iteration on both its children. So we will perform DFS on this child node and DFS on this child node. And it will keep on populating the swapping list. So let's try and understand this case once more. So the first thing that we are going to do, we will check the current node value is equal to the current expected value or not. If it is not equal, we'll reject the case. If it is equal, we'll continue the iteration. Since in this case it's equal, we'll continue the iteration and then we move on to the next pointer and next expected value is 3. So we will check whether currents node dot left child is equal to the expected value, which is not in this case. That means there is a possibility that its right child will surely match. And since its right child may match, we'll add to our swapping list the first node, because you need to perform one swap operation on the current node. Also, we will invoke the DFS on its right child first, followed by its left child. That means you will call the DFS on its right child and continue the operation first. So DFS of right followed by left, then left, if swapping needs to be done. And since let's continue with this, 3 matches with the current node and there's no further childs, so we'll ignore the case. This is pretty straightforward. There's a match, move ahead with the iteration, then we get 2, and then we'll perform the DFS on its left child. So pretty straightforward way. Had no swaps required, we would have performed DFS on its left child first and then its right child, because that's a regular case of pre-order traversal and you don't need any swap, so you don't need to change anything in the traversal order. I hope this part is clear to you, and in the end the swapping list will give us our desired result. So let's try and understand with by another example. We have 1 here and let's start the iteration. So 1 matches with this, and we'll continue the operation and we'll check whether current nodes dot left child matches with the expected value or not. The expected value doesn't match, that means you need to perform one swap operation on the parent node, which is 1. So swapping list will add 1 to it, and we will perform DFS on its right child first. DFS on its right child, that means DFS on this node and this value. So we will call it recursively, and since this matches and there's no further child, we'll continue the operation and then we'll perform DFS on its right child, the root's right child, I mean. So this first and this then followed by this. So DFS on 2, previous was DFS on 3. So let's continue the iteration, and since 2 matches with the current value, that's well and good. We'll continue the iteration, and then the expected value is 5. And we'll check whether 2 dots left child is equal to 5 or not. Since it's not equal, that means there is a possibility that right child may match. We'll add 2 to the swapping list, and we will invoke DFS on its right child first, followed by left. So we'll call DFS on right, it matches. So this matches with this. We'll continue the iteration and then we'll call DFS on its left child. So DFS on its left child, which is 4, and again it matches. That's well and good. So in the end, we have our swapping nodes, swapping list nodes 1 and 2 as our answer. And whenever there's a mismatch in terms of the value, we'll abort the process and we'll return -1 as an answer. So the number of times you are iterating through all the nodes is 1s, therefore the time complexity becomes order of n, and the space complexity becomes log n by virtue of the recursion stack, a log n because that's equal to the depth of the tree. And if you still don't have clarity, a complete clarity with respect to the solution, don't worry, you'll understand it fully in the coding part. So moving on to the coding part. Variable new array list, and let's call it to be swapped nodes. To be swapped nodes, and also I'll define one global variable for the iteration in the expected list or voyage. So in the end, I'll simply return my to be swapped nodes, and I'll create a DFS method that is accepting 3 things: the current route, the voyage, and to be swapped nodes. If that returns true, that means there is a possibility to have a complete match after n number of swaps, whatever n could be. And if it returns true, I'll simply return my answer in that case. Otherwise, I'll return minus 1. Reject case, that's the reject case, and reject case dot add minus 1 and return reject case. Pretty straightforward. And let's try the helper method now. So private, I'll return a boolean from this method and I'll pass, name it as DFS. I'll pass in three parameters, tree node root, followed by the voyage and the answer list, nodes to be swapped. And let's try this up. If for the case root becomes null, that means it's a happy case, we return true. And let's continue with the iteration. If root dot val is not equal to voyage of current index, the current value, that's again the failure case, will return. Otherwise, we'll increment the value of I. So now let's check if my root dot left is not equal to null and root dot left dot value is not equal to the voyage of I. If that is the case, then that means you definitely need to perform one swapping operation on the root. So we'll add to be add root to the to be swapped nodes, and we need to perform DFS on its right child first, followed by the left one. So let's call DFS on the right child first, followed by the left one. Root dot right, and we'll pass voyage and to be swapped nodes, and whatever the result of this is, we are fine with it. But the important thing is you need to perform the DFS in the reverse fashion, because you have performed one swap operation. Otherwise it's a happy case and we need to perform the DFS in a regular fashion. So we'll call it on the left first and then the right one. Pretty straightforward. And let's try this up. Looks good. And let me just submit it. Accepted. What is the time complexity of this approach? The TC is order of n. You are visiting all the nodes once. And SC is order of log n, where n is the number of nodes, and this is also equal to the height of the tree. Thanks for watching it. Hope you enjoyed it.